Hi everyone, my name is Raziel, and I am a tech lead in Pytorch. And today I have some exciting news on the developer productivity front. As you probably already know, Pytorch's mission is to accelerate the path from research prototyping to production deployment. This is important not only to reduce the cost from taking a model into a product, but because we know both research and product development are highly iterative. And being able to loop back product feedback to research in quick iterations translates into better models for the target use case. In order to make this happen, we operate under four guiding principles. First, we always enable cutting-edge research, and we want to co-develop with many stakeholders. We are also modular to allow users to only use what they care about, and we are performant and production-grade. This has never been more important than in the already big and growing on-device ML ecosystem, where on one hand, being able to easily go from idea to prototype on the actual target device is key to meet the more stringent resource restrictions of mobile devices. And on the other hand, we want to enable the large community of mobile developers. With the goal of reducing the friction to create novel ML-based mobile solutions, we introduced Pytorch Live. During the rest of the talk, Roman will cover the details of why exactly Pytorch Live is and how it works.
Thanks, Raziel. If you're an ML researcher or mobile developer, this is for you. I'm Roman, and I'm a software engineer on the AI Experiences team at Meta AI. Today, I will be talking about what Pytorch Live is, what Pytorch Live currently supports, what you can expect from Pytorch Live in the future, and how you can get started with it. Currently, Pytorch Live is a set of tools to build mobile AI-powered experiences, but it will continue to grow over time. These tools support building mobile AI-powered apps that run on both Android and iOS platforms. Now, instead of having to write the same app twice in two different programming languages, Pytorch Live uses JavaScript as a unified language to write apps for both platforms. To achieve this, Pytorch Live is powered by Pytorch Mobile and React Native. First, Pytorch Mobile powers the on-device inference. Second, React Native is a best-in-class JavaScript library for building visual interactive user interfaces for Android, iOS, and other platforms. Both are active and flourishing open source projects with tons of examples and tutorials. Here are three highlights of Pytorch Live. First, a command line interface which quickly sets up a mobile app development environment and bootstraps mobile app projects. Second, a data processing API which prepares and integrates custom models to be used with Pytorch Live. Third, a cross-platform API which builds mobile AI-powered apps for Android and iOS. For example, if you want to showcase a mobile net model that runs on Android and iOS, it would have taken days to configure the project and build the user interface. With Pytorch Live, it cuts the cost in half and you don't need to have Android and iOS developer experience. And here's how it works. Let's start with the command line interface, or CLI for short. The CLI reduces the setup costs for mobile app development and helps you to set up a mobile app project for Pytorch mobile models in just a few minutes using simple commands. The setup dev command will install development dependencies including tooling like Yarn, Watchman, and CocoaPods, SDKs like OpenJDK and Android SDK, and an Android emulator. And this is a one-time install, so it takes a few minutes depending on the internet speed and computer. Once the development dependencies are installed, the init command allows you to initialize a new Pytorch Live app project. And this project contains all native code necessary to run Android and iOS. It also includes working examples for image classification, object detection, and natural language processing. Lastly, the run Android and run iOS commands build and run the app either in the emulator or on a physical device. This is a great starting point for you to adapt any of these examples, and of course, you can bring in your own Pytorch mobile models. Now that we've set up the mobile app project, let's look at how to integrate your own models into Pytorch Live. One challenge when building AI-powered apps is the integration with data from device sensors or user input. The data processing steps are often not part of the model and need to be programmed additionally. For example, integrating an image classification model to work with the camera input requires custom data preprocessing steps to convert a 3Gen RGB image to a tensor. In reverse, the model output needs to be post-processed, returning a consumable data format, such as an image class. And this would need to be done for both Android and iOS. Pytorch Live offers a cross-platform data processing specification that abstracts processing steps and makes it possible to integrate ML models on different platforms. It allows you to more easily share models with others in the community. To add an ML model in Pytorch Live, we first need to include such a data processing specification. And the specification is in a JSON format that describes the data processing steps for our model. Let me show you what that looks like for an image classification model such as MobileNet. A specification consists of two parts, a pack definition and an unpack definition. The pack converts input data such as an image to a tensor. The unpack converts the model output into consumable data. The tensor from image transforms an image to a tensor using three transforms: a center crop transform, a scale transform, and an RGB normalization. The unpack definition will compute the argmax on the model output and return it as a result. The specification can also define variables, prefixed with a dollar sign, which allows you passing in params with the model call. The processing specification needs to be bundled as an extra file with the model, and this can be done during the model export in Python. Pytorch Live comes with a selection of transformations implementing best practices for image classification, object detection, and natural language processing. We plan on supporting a wider range of ML model domains and also releasing a flexible data processing API exposing functions like Torch argmax or Torch vision transforms from the C++ APIs directly to JavaScript. And this way, you can choose to include the data processing as part of the ML model or have it be part of the app logic. Now that we've set up the mobile app project and prepared a model, let's see how to use the model in an app. Building apps that work across different platforms requires expertise in multiple programming languages and therefore increases the cost to showcase models on different devices. Pytorch Live uses JavaScript, and it can be used to build apps for Android and iOS. Pytorch Live comes with a set of examples for image classification, object detection, and NLP. If your model is in any of these categories, you can plug and play your model without the need to program a user interface. But you can also build your own user interface to showcase your model. On top of basic user interface components from React Native, Pytorch Live provides a camera component for image-based ML model use cases, a canvas component to give you the flexibility to draw primitives, for example, drawing bounding boxes around detected objects in an image, or creating freeform drawing canvases to feed drawings into a handwritten digit classifier. And lastly, a mobile API to run ML inference. Let's have a look at an example on how to call the MobileNet model from before. First, put the model anywhere in your app project folder, which allows you to require the model using a relative path. Second, create a React Native component to showcase your model. Third, add the Pytorch Live camera component with an mCapture callback. Fourth, call the model with the captured image from the camera. You can pass in values for variables defined earlier in the data processing specification. Last, get the top image class based on the model result and use it in your app logic. And that's it. We'd love to see what you all create. If you publish your apps, tweet with the hashtag Pytorch Live and we'll retweet some of them from the Pytorch Live account. And here's how you're getting involved with Pytorch Live. Visit the Pytorch Live website for tutorials and API documentation. Check out the Pytorch Live GitHub repository for the source code to make suggestions, report issues, and contribute pull requests. And join the Discord channel to connect with the community and start discussions. So, what's next for Pytorch Live? This is our initial approach at making it easier for you to build mobile apps and showcase ML models to the community. It is also an opportunity to take this a step further by building a thriving community for ML researchers and mobile developers and share and utilize Pytorch mobile models and engage in conversations with each other. There are also short-term technical improvements that will be coming to Pytorch Live in the future. As mentioned earlier, we're working on a flexible data processing API to support custom data processing steps. The data processing API will be highly inspired by the Pytorch C++ and Python APIs, so you can transfer your learnings from previous uses of Pytorch. We will also be adding support for other ML domains that work with audio and video data. We hope you have a great time using Pytorch Live. Thanks for watching.